So hello everyone, my name is Adrien Varret and this video is going to present the paper using constraint programming to generate benzenoid structures in theoretical chemistry. It was written by Yannick Carissant, Denis Aguebom-Régnier, Nicolas Perkovic, Cyril Theriou and me, and we all come from Aix-Marseille University from France. So this paper is going to talk about a specific kind of molecules called benzenoids, which are a subfamily of hydrocarbons, molecules that are only made by hydrogen and carbon. And these molecules have the particularity of having their carbon building cycles of size 6, so hexagons. If we look at the figure A and B, you can see two examples of well-known benzenoids with the benzene and the anthracene. Then you have to know that we are only interested by interactions between carbons, so we are not going to represent hydrogens, and this representation is depicted on figure C for the benzene and figure D for the anthracene. Then you have to know that in chemistry there are some problematics related to these molecules, and in this paper we chose to focus on one of them, which is being able to generate benzenoid structures having specific properties. This problem is important for chemists because it allows them to generate specific kinds of molecules and predict some of their chemical properties. And this paper is going to answer the following question: how can constraint programming be useful to generate benzenoid structures? In this paper, we are firstly going to present a little reminder about constraint programming. Then we will present an existing algorithm able to generate all the benzenoid structures of n hexagons for a given integer n. And after this, we are going to present a general constraint programming model able to generate all the non-symmetrical benzenoids having a given number of hexagons. Then we are going to present three blocks of variable and constraints called modules that we can add to the general model and that are able to generate benzenoids having a tree shape, also called catacondensed benzenoids, benzenoids having a rectangular shape, and benzenoids having holes, also called coronoids. And please note that we also implemented a module able to generate benzenoids invariant by rotation and mirroring, but it will not be detailed here. So let's begin with a little reminder about constraint programming. We call a constraint satisfaction problem, or a CSP, a set of three values x, d, and c for variables, domains, and constraints, and solving a CSP is equivalent to check if it exists an assignment of all the variables of x with the values of D which satisfy all the constraints of C, and this problem is a well-known NP-complete problem. Now, our implementations are using the library ChocoSolver. It is a Java library that allows us to represent CSP models, and the main interest of this library is that it offers a specific kind of variable called the graph variable. And these variables represent graphs, and their domains are defined by the set of all the subgraphs between a given lower and upper bounds. And Choco also offers some graph-related constraints, like a cycle, connected, or some constraint about the number of vertices or edges. Now, about the existing work, in 2002, Brinkman et al. Presented an algorithm able to generate all the benzenoid structures of n hexagons for a given n. The main idea of this algorithm is to add the hexagon successively. It is very effective, but it has the following drawbacks. Firstly, it is unable to generate benzenoids with holes, so coronoids. And the figure below shows us this smallest coronoid. And moreover, it is unable to generate specific kinds of benzenoids, because we have to modify the algorithm for each new kind of molecule we want to generate. And about the work we did, we want to create a CSP model able to solve the benzenoid generation problem, or BGP, defined as follows: given a set of structural properties P, J generate all the basenoid structures that satisfies all the properties of P. And to do this, we chose to perform a two-step approach by defining a general CSP model able to generate all the non-symmetric basenoid structures of n hexagons for a given integer n. Then we want to add to this model different blocks of variables and constraints corresponding to additional properties. Now, before going further, I have to introduce you two little definitions. We call the hexagon graph of a basenoid the graph obtained by creating a new vertex for each hexagon. Then two vertices are connected by an edge if the associated hexagons are adjacent. The figure right here shows us a well-known basenoid, the coronal on figure A, and its hexagon graph on figure B. Moreover, we call a coronoid of size C the molecule obtained by adding successively C crowns of hexagons. So the figure right here shows us the coronoid of size 2 on figure A, of size 3 on figure B, and of size 4 on figure C. Then we can easily see that any basenoid of size n can be embedded in the coronoid of size k of n equal to the integer part of n plus 1 over 2 plus 1. We chose to embed our basenoids in coronoid because we need a finite domain for our model. And moreover, given a basenoid, all its symmetries are embeddable in the same coronoid. Now, I am going to detail you the general model we implemented. It has to solve the BGP problem I presented before. So given an integer n, generate all the non-symmetric basenoid structure having n hexagons. So we denote C of n, the hexagon graph of the coronoid of size n. And about the new variable, we have xg, a graph variable, which will correspond to the hexagon graph of the basenoid solution. Its domain is defined by the set of all the subgraphs of the coronoid of size k of n. Then we have xv, a set of Boolean variables, so variables having 0 or 1 has domain, and each of these variables will be connected to the existence of one vertex of xg. And about the constraints, we fixed the first one called no vertices channeling that connect each vertex of xg to a variable of xv. So if a vertex is in xg, then the value of the associated variable will be equal to 1 and 0 otherwise. And then we are going to specify that xg must be connected, and it can be done by using the connected constraint offered by Choco. Now, we want to represent the fact that there is no holes of one hexagons. So we implemented the following constraints, which say that if given a vertex V, if the sum of the variable associated to its neighborhood is equal to 6, so if its 6 neighbors are present in the solution, then the variable of V has to be equal to 1, so V has to be in the solution 2. At this part, we are able to generate all the basenoids of n hexagons for a given integer n, but we cannot generate non-symmetric molecules. And to fix this problem, we have to add three constraints in order to break the symmetries. We implemented two first constraints specifying that xg must have at least one vertex on the top and left borders, and we can do this by applying the same constraint on the variable connected to the vertices of these borders. And to conclude, we are going to use the Lexlid constraint in order to avoid symmetries by axes and rotation. Now, I am going to introduce you three kinds of modules, so blocks of variables and constraints, that we can add to the general model in order to add some structural properties to the built basenoid. The first module will be used to generate basenoids with tree shape. So you have here some example of this kind of molecules that we can generate. This kind of molecules are called catacondensed basenoids. And in this case, it's very simple because we just have to add a tree constraint over XG, constraint provided by Shoko. And the second model, more interesting, will be used to generate benzenoids having a rectangular shape. So the figure right here shows us some examples of rectangle benzenoids that we are able to generate. Now, given the number of hexagon n required in the general model, we denote W max equal to k of n and H max equal to 2 times k of n minus 1. These values are corresponding to the maximal dimensions of the benzenoids that we want to generate. And we also consider two sets of vertices, L and C, which will correspond to the lines and columns of the hexagon graph of the coronenoid of size k of n. So, if we look at the example right here, we have the coronenoid of size 2 on figure A, its hexagon graph on figure B, and its lines and columns on figure C. So, if we look at the lines and columns, we have 1 and 2 for the first line, 3 and 4 for the second line, etc. And for the columns, we have 1, 2, 1, 3, 6, and 2, 4, 7. Then we are going to add two variables to the general model, xw having a domain from 1 to w max and xh having a domain from 1 to h max. And these variables will denote the dimensions of the built benzenoids. And about the constraints, we want that lines and columns must be contiguous. So we are going to specify that the value of a variable associated to a vertex of a line or a column has to be greater or equal than the following element. So we don't want to have a serial of hexagons, then a whole and another serial of hexagons. And we also want that if a line or a column exists, then its size must be equal to xw or xh xh for lines and xw for columns. And we can do this by applying a sum constraints on each lines and columns. And the last module is used to generate benzenoids with holes, also called coronoids. Remember that a hole is formed by the absence of at least two adjacent hexagons and must be entirely surrounded by present hexagons. So, if we look at these figures, you can see some examples of coronoids that we are able to generate. And please remember that the Brinkmann et al. Algorithm I presented before is unable to generate this kind of molecule. So, for this module, we are going to add two new graph variables, xh and xc, having the same domain that xg. So, given the benzenoid solution represented by xg in red in this figure, xh is going to represent a possible way to dig in xg by removing some of its hexagon, like it is represented on the second figure, and xc will represent the result of this removal and will represent the coronoid solution. So, then we add three sets of binary variables, x, xc, x, xh, and y, xh, which will be respectively connect to the vertices of xc, the vertices of xh, and the edges of xh. And about constraints, we firstly had three channeling constraints that connect the variables of x, xc, to the node of xc, the variables of xxh to the node of xh, and the variables of yxh to the edges of y of xh. Then we have to add two constraints that specify that xc and xh are subgraph of xg. And to do this, we used the subgraph constraint offered by Shoko. We also have to represent the fact that only fully surrounded vertices of xg can be vertices of xh, and to do this we had the following constraint, which says that if a vertex is in xh, Then the sum of the variable associated to its neighborhood has to be equal to 6. Then we want to represent the fact that a single hexagon cannot form a whole. It can be represented by a constraint specifying that each vertex of XH has to be must have a degree greater than 0. Then we also want that each solution has at least one hole, so we specify that XH has to have at least one vertex by applying a sum constraint on the variable of XXH. Now we want to represent the fact that XC and XH are forming a partition. We are going to add a logical constraint that says that a vertex is in XC if and only if it is in XG and not in XH. And to conclude, we add a constraint that specifies that XC has to be connected. So our model has the following advantages. Firstly, it is able to generate coronoids and like the algorithm of Brinkmann et al. I presented before. Then we have seen that we can easily add or combine modules to generate specific kinds of benzenoids. So it makes our model adaptable to the needs of chemists. And to sum up, I presented you a general constraint programming model able to generate all the non-symmetric benzenoids having n hexagons for a given integer n. I also presented you three modules that we can add to the general model able to generate benzenoids with a tree shape, also called the catacondensed benzenoids, or benzenoids with a rectangular shape, also benzenoids with a rectangular shape, or benzenoids with holes, also called coronoids. We also implemented a little module that is able to generate benzenoids invariant by rotation or mirroring, but we didn't detail it in this presentation. And we also have seen that we can easily add this module to generate specific kind of molecule. We can easily add new module to generate specific kinds of molecule and being adapted to the need of chemists. And about perspectives, we are working on the generation of other kinds of benzenoids, like benzenoids having a rhombus shape, for example. Then you have to know that in this paper we focused on structural properties, but we are also working on the modelization of some chemical properties. It will be presented in a future paper. We also presented in this conference, so in CP 2020, a paper which describes how can we use constraint programming to compute resonance energy of benzenoids, and we want to make some studies by computing the resonance energy of molecules that we generated with the model I presented you. And we also want to study the limits of our approach by trying to find some properties that we are unable to generate. And to finish, we are performing optical spectrum computation on a set of more than 8,000 molecules that we generated, and depending the results, all of this may be presented in a future chemistry papers. And to conclude with this presentation, we really liked to work on this subject and present you some interesting applications of constraint programming. So that's all, and thank you for your attention.